Good morning, students. I, Purnima, welcome you to my class. And today we are going to do a new topic, that is reported speech. Now, reported speech is also known by the name of narration. Okay? So, reported speech is direct and indirect. Is also known by the name of narration. Okay, and in your question paper, children, you have to change from direct to indirect speech. You have to change from direct to indirect speech. Indirect speech is also known as reported speech, right? Okay, so now, children, I will be telling you that what is a reported or reproduction of the words of a speaker is known as. So, children, when we tell the same word of the speaker, or reporting or reproduction of the words of a speaker is known as narration. This reproduction or reporting can be done in two ways. So first way is direct speech. And the second is indirect speech. So reproduction of the word of the speaker can be done through direct speech and indirect speech. So what is a direct speech, children? When we speak the same word of the speaker, the exact word of the speaker which comes from our mouth is known as direct speech. Okay. So you can write it, this definition: when we present the speaker words exactly without making any changes in them, this is known as direct speech. So when the exact word of the speaker is presented without making any changes, this is known as direct speech. Now, children, for your information, let me tell you, this is a verbal, but when you write, how you write the exact word of the speaker? So the exact word of the speaker is written in inverted comma. Whatever the word is written in inverted comma, that is the direct speech. Now, for example, George said to Mark, "I am going to my school." Now, children, close the inverted comma and put a full stop inside the inverted comma. So here you can see, George said to Mark. Now, children, two persons are there, and the name of one person is George, and what he is saying to Mark, whatever he is saying, his words are in the inverted comma. So those words which are inside the inverted comma tell you the exact word of the speaker, and this exact word of the speaker is direct speech. This word, exact word of the speaker, is known as direct speech. So in this example, George said to Mark, these are the words, exact word of the speaker, because it is written in the inverted comma. So I am going to my school, this is written in the inverted comma. So this is a direct speech. We keep the exact statement of the speaker in inverted comma. So whatever the exact word of the speaker was, whatever the exact word of the or the statement of the speaker was, that is put in the inverted comma. indirect or reported speech. Now we will come to, I will tell you what is a indirect speech. Now first of all, student, indirect speech is also known as by the name of reported speech. So this indirect speech is also known as reported speech. Okay, now when so children, when we express the speaker words in our own words, when we speak the speaker word, what are the speaker word which is written in the inverted comma? So the exact of word of the speaker, children, how this word is told to somebody else, okay, that is an indirect speech. So when we express the speaker's word in our own words, when we speak the speaker's words in our own words, making due changes, we have to make certain changes, and that I will be telling you which changes we have to make. So it is known as indirect speech. And I also told you indirect speech is also known by the name of what? Reported speech. Yes. Okay, so now George told Mark that he was going to his school. He was going to his school. George said to Mark that he was going to his school. This is a indirect speech. So once again I revise you, what is a direct speech? The exact word of the speaker is direct speech, and it is written in inverted comma. Indirect speech, which is also known by the name of reported speech, it is to express the speaker words in our own words. That is how you are going to tell that speaker's word in your own words. That is an indirect speech. Okay, now children, I will be telling you different parts of the narration. I will be telling you different part of the narration. Now what I am going to tell you, different part of narration. Well, so see this. George said to Mark, this is one part, and this is another part. So first part is George said to Mark. This is known as reporting part. This is known as reporting part. And I am going to my school. This part which is there in the inverted comma, this is a reported part. What is it? This is a reported part. Okay, so two main part of narration is, one is outside the inverted comma, and this is known as reporting part. One is inside the inverted comma, that is a reported part. Okay, both the parts have their own importance. And children, this is a reporting verb. Now this reporting verb plays a very important role in changing direct speech to indirect speech. Okay, this plays a very important role in changing direct speech to indirect speech. Okay, so let me, so So, children, I will be telling you what we have done till now. So, first of all, what is a reported speech? Reported speech is also known as narration, or it is also known as direct indirect. Then there are direct speech. It is the exact word of the speaker. It is written in the inverted comma. And then also indirect speech, how you express the exact word of the speaker in your own word, that is indirect speech. It is also known as by the name of reported speech. Then I describe the two different part of the reported speech. The first part, which is outside the inverted comma, is known as reporting part. And the part which is inside the inverted comma is reported part. Okay, you can see I'm circling. And the most important thing here is reporting work. The most important thing here is reporting work. Okay, so three things you have to see, student, before changing from direct to indirect. First, what is the reporting part and what is the reported part? The most important thing is the verb of the reporting part. How to change direct speech into reported speech? Before we start changing a direct speech into a reported speech, we should keep the following things in mind. No change is done in the tense of a reporting part. So children, when we change from direct to indirect, you have to see two things. What thing you will see? First thing, no changes is done in the reporting part. It is reporting verb that determines the changes. But children, we don't do any changes in the first part, that is reporting part. But reporting verb determines all the changes. This word determines the changes. So the tense of the reporting verb should be studied very carefully. Why? Because children, we have to see if the tense of the reporting verb is in the present tense, then some other changes will be there while changing from direct to indirect speech. If it is in future tense, some other changes will be there from changes from direct to indirect speech. And if it is in reporting verb will be in past tense, then the other changes will be there from changing from direct to indirect speech. Okay, so what do we have to see? We have to see, children, there will be no changing of tenses in the reporting part, but children, it is the reporting verb which determines all the changes. Okay, it determines all the changes. Now the most important thing is that, children, when reporting verb is in present tense. So now I'm going to tell you the procedure that how to change from direct speech to indirect speech. How to change from direct speech to indirect speech. So I'm going to tell you the procedure. Okay, so first thing, when you see that the reporting verb is in present tense or in future tense, though you have to see five changes will take place. But if the reporting verb is in past tense, then seven changes will take place. Once again, I repeat this thing. When reporting verb is in present tense or in past tense, then five changes takes place while converting from reporting direct speech to indirect speech. When reporting verb is in the past tense, then seven types of changes takes place from converting from direct to indirect speech. So now let's see when reporting verb is in the present tense or in future tense. Okay. When reporting verb is in present or future tense, so five changes will take place if the reporting verb is in present tense and in future tense. Okay, so first thing, children, when we change from direct to indirect speech, then we have to change something in the reported part, and that is says to will change into tells. If object is there in the reporting part. Okay. Second, remove the inverted commas. So children, you have to see this thing, that in the reporting part, if your reporting verb is in present tense or if your reporting verb is in future tense, then you have to see two things. What two things you have to change? You have to see that children, five changes will take place when reporting verb is in the present tense or in the future tense. So first changes will, if object is present in the reporting part, then says to will change into tells. Immediately you have to remove the inverted comma and the comma which is in center. As soon as you remove the center comma, the conjunction that will be put instead of the center comma. Then children, change in the pronouns of the reported part. If the pronoun will be changes, then verb in the reported part will change according to the changed pronoun. Then the verb will be changes in the reporting part according to the changed pronoun. Okay. So this happens when reporting verb is in present tense or in future tense. Then five changes will take place. And I've written only two changes on the board. So what is the first change? Says to will change into tell, and will say will change into will tell if object is there in the reporting part. My second point is that you have to remove the inverted comma. Third point is that remove the central comma and use the conjunction that. You have to use the conjunction that. Okay, so this is there when reporting verb is in present tense or in future tense. Now two other changes takes is going to change place. So what is that? Changes in the pronouns in the reported part. So children, whatever is the pronoun is there in the reported part, that will be changed. That will be changed. Okay. And then the last one, change in the verb of reporting part according to the changed pronoun. Change in the verb of the reporting part according to the changed pronoun. Okay. So this you have to see. Now I'm going to tell you an example. Anne says to me, you are my friend. Okay. So this is the sentence. Now you can see children, and tells me what it will become, and tells me why you have to remove two, because this is object and this is subject and this is reporting verb. So children, first of all here you have to write tells because object me is there. Now you have to see, now an is the reporting verb which is in present tense, so the tenses will not change, only five changes will take place. First you have to remove the inverted comma, then you have to remove the center comma, and you have to write the conjunction that. You and tells me that he is my friend. Okay, no, I am her friend. Okay, now why this happened, this I am going to tell you. And says I am her friend. You are my friend. You changes according to, this is second person, and you have to, me is second person, and so here I is there. I is there, so with I we always use the verb am, that's why the verb am is here instead of are. And my is the second person, and instead of my we have written her, and then friend. Okay, and there is no change in the tense when reporting verb is in the present tense or future tense. Okay, so this is all, and now I will be telling you the major thing, that how this sentence was changed. So students, the video will remain, this rule is applied if the reporting verb is in future tense also. Okay, this tense is applied when the reporting verb is in future tense also. For example, will say will change into will tell if object is there in the reporting part. Okay, and then you have to remove the inverted comma, and after removing the inverted comma you have to use the conjunction that. Then children, you have to change the pronoun. And once again I would remind you that the change of pronoun is again a very important topic to be explained in this part. Okay, and you should know what is the subject, children, what is subject of the first person or the second person or the third person, then only it will be easier for you to change it. Okay, to change the pronoun. And children, when the pronoun will be changed, then the verb will automatically change according to the changed pronoun. The verb will automatically change with the changed pronoun. Okay, so this here you have to see. Now, so children, today I have discussed that when the changes will be, when the reporting verb is there in the, with the present or future, then five changes will take place. First, children, first change you have to, instead of says to or will say, you have to write will tell or say tell. Okay, if object is there. Alright, like here it is, one thing here you have to note, children, if object is there. Suppose if we have, if me would not have been there here. Just imagine if me would not have been there. So here an says, then tell will not come. Then an says. Okay, since it was here to me, this is the object. If object is there, then it will change into else. Me. You have to remove to also. Okay. So if object is there, then it will be changed in the reporting part. Alright, now pronoun is changed, you can see you is changed into I and my is changed into her. Now if pronoun is changed, so the verb is changed automatically with a changed pronoun. Like with R is used with you, but here am is used with I. So you can see the verb have automatically change here. My is changing to her. Okay, my friend, her friend. So this is very important, children. Now in my next class, I will be telling you how the pronouns are changed. Okay, you have to see the subject and object and the reporting part, and then also you have to see the pronoun of the first person, second person and third person of the reported part. First person will change according to the subject of the reporting part. Second person will change according to the object of the reporting part. And children, if third person is there, then no changes will be there. So this you have to remember. Okay, this is the most important thing which I want to tell to you. And this, I end my video here. Thank you and have a nice day. In my tomorrow video, I will be continuing this, the same lesson. Goodbye.